Welcome to this video about using breakpoints in TRACE32. The first part of this tutorial talks about software and on-chip breakpoints. Each one of these implementations has its specificity. When using a software breakpoint, the opcode at the breakpoint address is patched by a special instruction to stop the program. Then the original opcode is restored when the program is stopped. In contrast to software breakpoints, on-chip breakpoints are hardware resources provided by the cores in form of breakpoint registers. The number of available on-chip breakpoints depends on the used processor architecture and is typically between 1 and 16. After this, we will speak about breakpoint types, including program and read-write breakpoints. Program breakpoints stop the processor when the instruction at the breakpoint address is executed. Access breakpoints stop the execution when the breakpoint address is accessed in read, write, or read-write, depending on the breakpoint type. This tutorial is presented with the TRACE32 release version of September 2015. And I will be using TRACE32 PowerView for ARM, but the same concepts apply to other architectures and the commands to set breakpoints are also the same. So let's start. In TRACE32 there is more than one way to set a breakpoint. Click on Break. Set, click here and then select your symbol. Choose the breakpoint type, then click on OK. For program breakpoints, you can simply double-click on the line on which you wish to break. A second double-click here removes the breakpoint. Or do a right mouse click and select breakpoints and then program. You can set a read-write breakpoint by a right mouse click on the variable and selecting breakpoints, then choose the access type. This red vertical indicator in the left marks all code lines for which a program breakpoint is set. Access breakpoints are also marked by a red indicator when displaying the variable. In this example, clicking on Go will help the processor on the first breakpoint. On-chip breakpoints are useful for debugging code in cases where the memory cannot be accessed or could be overwritten by the application. You can create one by clicking on the break button, then set, type the symbol, then choose the on-chip implementation. TRACE32 sets per default program breakpoints as software breakpoints. If setting the software breakpoint fails, TRACE32 always tries to set an on-chip breakpoint. This behavior can be changed using the menu break implementation. You can force in this window TRACE32 to use software or on-chip breakpoints for program breakpoints. And as you can see here, access breakpoints can only be on-chip. The command map.beOnChip is useful to tell the debugger to set only on-chip breakpoints in a predefined range. So, if you try to set a breakpoint outside of this range, it would be a software breakpoint. if this is the default implementation, of course. But when you put a breakpoint on this range, it will be an on-chip breakpoint. Click on MISC memory map to see the full mapping that your system has. So these are some tips. Everything that was done here with the menus can be translated to commands. You can drag and drop a breakpoint from the break.list window to get the full command that can be also used with practice scripts. If you want to keep all the breakpoints that you have, you can click on store, name your file .cmm, and you can load this file later to have the same breakpoint configuration. You can take a look at the documentation of the break command group. Type a break.set, then press the F1 button. So here we come to the end of our tutorial. You can visit these links for more information. Thank you for watching.